The same way I was with Moses, my servant. The same way I will be with you. The same way I walk with Moses, the same way I will walk with you. The same way I spoke with Moses is the same way I will speak to you. The same way I use Moses, the same way I will use too. So you say I am too old, the God cannot use me. And King, I know. You believe or not, God is able to use you. God is able to use you. And God is able to use you. You are a chosen of God. When you are the chosen of God, do not neglect yourself. Do not put yourself at the place where God did not put you. God knows you are able to be used by Him. He can use you. He can use you. He can use you. He can use you. So why are you crying? So why are you afraid? You know, discouragement is the power that makes someone see himself is less than circumstances or less than a problem. Is something that can put someone at the position where he's supposed not to be. You know, discouragement is something can welcome fear. When someone is discouraged, it's only when he got a bad news he may be discouraged. Or when you get a bad testimony, you may be also discouraged. You know, discouragement is the friend of fear. Because when you are discouraged, you may be afraid of something. And when someone is afraid, he will not be able to do something what he's supposed to do. When someone is afraid, you may see his heart can start beeping quickly. When someone is afraid, his body will shake. You may ask, why are you shaking? He may say, I don't know, but I am afraid and all my body is shaking. When someone is afraid, you may see even he's sweating. When someone is afraid, sometimes he cannot move or do any step. When someone is afraid, he may lose control. When someone is afraid, he may be not able to run. Some of them, when he's afraid, you will see a person start running. He doesn't know where he's going because he's afraid. Other people, when they are afraid, they may cry. Yes. Some of them, they cannot sleep because they are afraid. They cannot sleep. Sometimes people are afraid of darkness. Sometimes people are afraid when they do not have something to eat. They may be afraid. People are afraid all the time. Say, what shall I do? I do not have a job. I'm afraid. They will kick me out from my apartment. I'm afraid. I have many bills to pay. I'm afraid. My friend is sick.
Rafiki yangu anaumwa.
I'm afraid.
Ninaogopa
to go somewhere.
Ninaogopa kwenda kusema.
I'm afraid.
Ninaogopa
to pray.
Ninaogopa kuomba.
I'm afraid.
Ninaogopa ask. Ninaogopa kuuliza.
He may be in need of something, but you will be afraid to ask.
Anaweza kuwa anahitaji kitu lakini anaogopa kuuliza.
Afraid to ask a question.
Anaogopa hata kuuliza swali.
Afraid to ask a direction.
Anaogopa hata kuuliza mwelekeo.
Afraid to eat.
Anaogopa hata kukula.
People are afraid of anything.
Watu wanaogopa vyote.
Afraid of dogs.
Wanaogopa hata na imbwa.
Afraid of mouse.
Wanaogopa hata na mapanya.
Afraid of everything, everything.
Wanaogopa kila kitu.
My friend and my sister.
Ndugu yangu.
Sometimes.
Wakati mwingine.
We are afraid.
Tunaogopa.
When we are alone.
Tunaogopa wakati tuko peke yetu.
You know. The fear is the weapon that Satan uses all the time to discourage children of God.
Woga ni kitu kenye shetani anatumikishaka sana kuvunja moyo watu wa Mungu.
Afraid.
Woga.
Fear is something that Satan uses all the time to discourage people.
Woga ni kitu kenye shetani anatumikishaka wakati mwingi kuvunja watu moyo.
He will give you many ideas, negative ideas to put you in the place where you suppose not to be.
Hata kupatia mawazo mengine, mawazo ya bongo ya mbaya, jua kuweke nafasi lenye
ideas of failure.
Hata kupatia tu mawazo ya kushindwa.
When Satan gives you the bad idea,
wakati shetani anakupatia mawazo mbaya,
just to discourage you,
atakuweka bonge ndani yako juu tu akuvunje moyo.
He will bring the fear in you to paralyze you.
Hata kuweka bonge ndani yako tu juu akuvunje.
He will bring it just to steal the blessings that God did give you.
Hata kuweka hiyo bonge juu tu Mungu akamate baraka yako ni Mungu anakupa.
He will use the fear just to steal the peace.
Hata atatumia hiyo woga tu abebe amani yako.
You know, peace is the blessings that comes from God.
Amani nayo ni baraka inatoka kwa Mungu.
Many people, they do not have a peace.
Ni watu wengi hawana amani.
You may have money, but you may not have a peace.
Unaweza kuwa uko na pesa lakini hauna amani.
You may be healthy, but you may miss something called peace.
Unaweza kuwa na afya nzuri lakini unakosa amani.
You may have anything that you want, but the peace, you may miss it.
Unaweza kuwa na kila kitu kenye unataka lakini amani hauna.
But Satan will use something called afraid, a fear, just to discourage you.
Sasa shetani anatumia woga juu ya kuvunja moyo.
Usually people are afraid when they find themselves they do not have a solution.
Watu wengine wanaogopa wakijikuta wako peke na hawana solution.
People are afraid when they found they do not have a solution. I know why I repeat this.
Ninarudia tena, watu wanaogopa sana wakijikuta hawana solution.
When they found themselves they are alone, there is no one there to help them.
Wakijikuta wako peke hakuna mtu wa kuwasaidia.
People will be afraid.
Watu wanaogopa hivyo.
I remember there is one man in the Bible.
Ninakumbuka kuna mwanamume mmoja wa Biblia.
I feel that person was afraid. That's why God told him, do not be afraid. I am with you.
Na fikiri ya mtu alikuwa na woga, ndio maana hata Mungu alimwambia usiogopi, maana ni
Joshua chapter 1 verse 5 to 6.
Joshua chapter ya kwanza verse ya 5 mpaka 6.
The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
no one will be able to stand before you all the days of your life.
Hakuna mtu ataweza kuweza kusimamia siku zako za maisha.
As I was with Moses,
kama jinsi nilikuwa na Musa,
I will be with you.
Nitakuwa na wewe pia.
I want to repeat. I want you to understand.
Ninapenda usikie hii.
Whenever you hear something God is speaking to someone or to encourage someone, means that word may belong to you if you believe it.
Wakati Mungu anakuwa anaongelea kuhusu juu ya mtu fulani, ndio inawezekana hiyo neno ni yako, inakuwa juu yako.
God is speaking to Joshua.
Mungu anaongea na Yeshua.
But today.
Lakini leo.
Even right now.
Leo sasa hivi.
God is speaking to you.
Mungu anaongea na wewe.
And God is speaking to your family.
Mungu anaongea na familia.
God is speaking to your
neighbor. Mungu anaongelea.
Now listen what God is saying to you.
Sasa usikie nini Mungu anakuongelea.
I was with Moses.
Kama jinsi nilikuwa na Musa.
I will be with you.
Nitakuwa na wewe pia.
I will never leave you or abandon you.
Sitakuacha wala sitakusaliti.
Be strong and courageous.
Uwe na nguvu na ujipe moyo.
For you shall cause these people to inherit the land that I swear to their father to give them.
vile naweza kutuma, naweza kusababisha watu waingie katika mji ile ambayo niliwaandalia.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today,
kwa leo,
God is speaking to someone in this place.
Mungu anaongea na mtu ndani ya kanisa
hili. As you know all the time.
Kama jinsi unajua wakati wote.
The word of God does not come by mistake.
Neno la Mungu halikui kwa bahati mbaya.
When God speaks something,
wakati Mungu anaongelea kuhusu kitu,
mean there is a solution somewhere.
Namaanisha huko solution.
God was speaking to Joshua.
Mungu alikuwa anaongea na Yoshua.
Say that you will not die.
Hala akamwambia hautakufa.
No man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life.
Hakuna mtu anayeweza kukushimamia siku zote za maisha yako.
Because the purpose of God, the plan of God was to bring his people in the new land.
Kwa sababu mpango wa Mungu ilikuwa ni kuwaleta watu wake katika nchi mpya.
And among all those people God didn't find just one person called Joshua.
Na katika watu wote hao Mungu alipata tu mwanamume mmoja.
And God said, I will protect you. You do not need to die, because if you die I will not be able to take my people in the new land.
Akasema nitakulinda hauwezi kufa, kwa sababu ukikufa siwezi kukamata watu wangu nikawapeleka katika mji mpya.
I will protect you.
Nitakulinda.
No one will stand before you.
Hakuna mtu atakushimamia.
No one will fight you.
Atakupiganisha.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God say,
na Mungu anasema,
the same way I was with Moses my servant.
Na kwa hiyo gisi nilikuwa na Musa.
The same way I will be with you.
Na ndio hivyo tutakuwa na wewe.
The same way I walked with Moses, the same way I will walk with you.
Kwa gisi nilitembea na Musa, leo gisi natembea na wewe.
Moses is the same way I will speak to you.
Mimi kwa gisi niliongea na Musa, ndio gisi naongea na wewe.
The same way I use Moses, the same way I will use too.
Gisi nilimuonesha Musa nikamuongoza, ndio gisi naona.
My brother and my sister.
Ndugu yangu.
Moses was a man like you and me.
Musa alikuwa ni mwanadamu kama wewe.
Moses was a human being like you and me.
Musa naye alikuwa ni mtu kama wewe.
Moses had the blood, the red blood like yours and mine.
Musa pia alikuwa na damu kama yako na yangu.
But this man called Moses.
Lakini huyo Musa,
he walked with God.
Alitembea na Mungu.
This man called Moses.
Huyo anaitwa Musa.
He operated the miracle.
Yeye alitenda miujiza.
The man called Moses.
Mwanaume anaitwa Musa.
He called God and God came down.
Alimuita Mungu na Mungu akakuja.
Moses.
Musa.
Praised God.
Alimtukuza Mungu.
Fight for them.
Aliomba Mungu awapiganie.
God fight for them.
Na Mungu akawapigania.
Moses.
Musa.
He fighted the sea the two parts.
Aligawa maji mara mbili.
The same way.
Na ndio hivyo hivyo.
God used Moses.
Kisi Mungu
alipigania. God is faithful.
Kwa sababu Mungu ni mwaminifu.
Again, God is faithful.
Mungu ni mwaminifu.
I repeat, God is faithful.
Utilia Mungu
ni mwaminifu. God did use Moses.
Kwa Mungu
alipigania. He is the same God can use you too.
Mungu
atakusaidia. I said God can use you too. You believe or not, God is able to use you. God is able to use you. And God is able to use you. You are the chosen of God. When you are the chosen of God, do not neglect yourself. Do not put yourself at the place where God did not put you. God knows you are able to be used by Him.
Anaweza
kutumia. He can use you.
Anaweza
kutumia. He can use you. So why are you crying?
Sasa kwa nini unalia?
So why are you afraid?
Kwa nini unaogopa?
God can use you.
Mungu anaweza
kutumia. He said to me.
Anasema
sasa.
The same way.
The same way I was with Moses.
Kisi nilikuwa na Musa.
Is the same way I will be with you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can we clap our hands for the glory of Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Do you believe that God can use you?
Je, unaamini kama Mungu anaweza kukutumia?
Do you believe that God can use you?
Unajua
Bible says.
Biblia inasema,
I will never leave you or abandon you.
Kamwe sitakuacha ama kukusaliti.
Why God spoke to this man all those words?
Kwa nini Mungu alimwongelesha huyu mtu hiyo te maneno?
He wanted this man called Joshua to trust in God and to believe in him.
Alipenda huyu mwanaume anaitwa Joshua amwamini.
Because all the time, people are thinking they are alone. God does not care about them.
Kwa sababu wakati wengi, wakati mingi watu wengi bana kama wako wao peke wanafikiria Mungu hayuko pamoja nao.
They think because their parents abandon them, then God will also abandon them.
Wanafikiria kwa sababu wazazi wao waliwasaliti, wanafikiria na Mungu naye atawasaliti.
Do you think God is like a human being?
Je, unafikiria Mungu yeye kama mwanadamu?
Do you think God is like your parents?
Unafikiria Mungu yeye kama wazazi wako?
If your friend abandon you, I'm here to tell you that God will never abandon you.
Kama rafiki yako bali kutupilia, niko hapa kukuambia kama Mungu hawezi kutupilia.
If you are living in the difficulty, doesn't mean that God rejected you.
Na kama uko naishi katika magumu, usifikiri kama Mungu anakuhukumu.
He said again, I will not abandon you.
Alisema tena,
I will not leave you alone.
Sitakuacha kamwe.
No matter what is going on in your family.
Haijalishi nini inaendelea
kwa wewe. No matter how is your situation, God will not leave you alone.
Haijalishi jinsi maisha yako iko, Mungu hatakuacha.
You may be sick today.
Unaweza kuwa mgonjwa.
But I am here again to tell you that God is with you. God is with you in your problems.
Mungu yuko pamoja na wewe mshida.
God is with you in your difficulty.
Mungu yuko pamoja na wewe mshida yako.
I will not leave you alone.
Sitokuacha kamwe.
I will not abandon you.
Sitokusaliti kamwe.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
be strong.
Uwe na nguvu.
And courageous.
Na ujipe moyo.
For you shall cause these people to inherit the land.
Unaweza kusababisha hao watu waingie katika nchi ile mpya.
Hallelujah. I want you to understand what I am about to speak here.
Napenda uelewe hiki nilikuwa pina nje kuongelesha.
God works all the time with people who believe in his word.
Mungu anatumika wakati wote na watu wale ambao wanaamini katika neno lake.
Again, God works all the time with people who believe his word.
Mungu anatembea na watu wale ambao wanaamini katika neno lake.
People who catch the word of God and say, this is my word, comes from the Lord.
Watu wale ambao wanakamata neno la Mungu wanasema hii ndio neno langu natoka kwa Mungu.
God is telling you that you will cause these people to inherit the land.
Mungu anasema hivi, anakuambia kama unaweza kusababisha hao watu waingie katika nchi.
Number one.
Kitu ya kwanza.
When you have the call of God.
Wakati unapata wito kwa Mungu.
When God calls you.
Wakati Mungu anakuita.
Or if there is a gift inside of you.
Ama kama kuko zawadi ndani yako.
Or if there is a blessing upon your life.
Ama kama kuko baraka kwa maisha yako.
You believe or not, you will be the first target of Satan.
Wewe utakuwa ni mtu wa kwanza utakamatwa na shetani.
Satan will follow you.
Shetani atakufuata.
Because he doesn't follow any person who is empty.
Kwa sababu yeye hamfuati mtu yote yule mwenye hana kitu.
Some of you do not know why problems are attacking you. You do not know why.
Wengine hamwezi leo kujua jioni ni mashida kuna mapata.
You do not know why your family problems are the problems. You do not know.
Labda haujui ni juu ya nini mashida kwa familia yako.
You do not understand why people are rejecting you. You do not know.
Labda haujui ni juu ya nini watu wako wanakukatala.
You mean your family, people of your family, your husband or wife is rejecting you. You do not understand.
Hata watu wa familia yako, bwana yako, bibi yako wanakukatala, lakini wewe haujui ni juu ya
nini. I am here to encourage you, my brother and my sister.
Niko hapa kukupa moyo ndugu yangu.
It's because there is something important in you.
Ni kwa sababu kuna kitu ya muhimu ndani yako.
Satan is attacking you to take it from you.
Shetani tu yeye anapenda kamate
kitu. Steal it from you.
Anapenda hakamate kitu kwa ndani yako.
If something inside of you
ndani yako
there is a blessing.
Kuna baraka.
He will follow you.
Atakufuata.
He will do his best.
Atajitahidi.
Finish you.
Atakutenda.
He will do his best.
Atakutenda.
Destroy your happiness.
Haribu.
He will do his best.
Atajitahidi.
Destroy everything you have. He will do his best
to
kill that blessing.
He
will do his best to kill that things that God has put in you. That's why you do not understand. And you say, why only me? Why my problem is bigger than others? You are the first target. Because you are the person who will bring your family in the new land.
Because
you are a person who takes your people to the place where there is a blessing. Maybe through you, your family can be blessed. Maybe through you, your friend can be blessed. Maybe through you, your neighbor may be blessed. Through you, maybe your family or your country can be blessed. Or through your children, one of them will be blessed. That's why he's attacking you. There is a call upon your life. There is a gift upon your life. There is a blessing upon your life. Never be discouraged. Never be discouraged. Do not go back. God has a promise upon your life. God has a promise upon your life. There is a promise upon your life. You are not a small person. You are not a small person. You are not a small person. Because you don't know what I'm talking about. Do not be afraid, my sister. Even you have problems, even things are not going well, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. There is a hope in your family. There is a hope in your life. Never be discouraged. You have the power. You have the power. You are different to other people. That's it. And there is another thing that can discourage people. This one you pray and there is no answer. Again, there is things that can discourage people when you pray and you do not have an answer. You pray, there's no answer, you may be discouraged. You pray, you fast, there is no answer. You may be discouraged. My question is upon that. Is God a liar, yes or not? Because he said himself in the Bible. In Jeremiah 33, verse 3. Jeremiah. God says, call unto me, and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things. Which you do not know. Call me, and I will answer you. I will show you great things and mighty things that you do not know. And why, when you pray, there is no answer? This is God. He's giving you a permission. Say pray. My question is, God is telling you to pray. And when you pray, there is no answer. Is God a liar, yes or no? On the side of God, there is no problem. Because God is faithful to accomplish his word. So when you pray, there is no answer. You need to check in your life. You need to check in your life. Check your word. Check how you pray. Check how you ask. Check how is your life. If your life is correct, you will get your answer. If your life is correct, you will get the answer. But if it is not correct, if something wrong is in your life, you will not get an answer. One thing can separate you with your God. Usually, I like to tell you, it's sin. It's sin. Sin can block your blessings. Sin can block your prayer to be heard by God. Sin can block you. Separate yourself with sin. What you are doing maybe does not please God. What you are speaking maybe does check his life.
Ni wakati sasa wa kila mtu kuchunguza maisha yake.
You may tell me my life is good. Okay. That's good. Oh, I'm a good person. That is something, God. Oh, yes, I pray. Yes, congratulations. So if you pray, and your life is the way it is today, what can you tell me today? How do you pray? How many times did you pray for sick people and got healed? How many times did you pray and you see miracles happen? My brother and my sister, God wants you to go far away from where you are. In your prayer, go far from where you are. In your faith, go far from where you are. Because God wants the time you pray, the same time you got your answer. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the life. Again, Jesus is the way. He showed us the way to pray. Jesus did not pass 3 days to resurrect Lazarus. Lazarus, come out! Lazarus, come out! My friend, that is the level God wants you to be. My friend, do not accept the weakness in prayer. Do not accept the weakness in prayer. You need to go deeper in your prayer. You need to go deeper in your prayer. Do not be afraid of prayer. Do not be afraid to go in the presence of God.
Hallelujah.
Some of you, when you rely on men, you will be discouraged. The third time I want to tell you, if you rely on people, you will be discouraged. Man is not faithful. He may help you today. He may help you after tomorrow. Then the other day he can help you. But the following day he will say, I am tired. Another day he will say, I do not have, I'm sorry. Man cannot satisfy you. Man does not have anything that you want to get. Man can help you in parts. If you rely on man, you will be discouraged. And you will refuse to stay with people. And you will say people are bad. Do not rely on men. Again, do not rely on men. Hallelujah. Amen. Again, any person who is not grateful to what people are doing upon me is lying. He is a dangerous person more than a witchcraft. How come someone can help you do something good to you and you give him bad things? Why? Someone is doing his best to please you and you give him bad things. Where come that spirit? Listen, when someone gives you even a glass of water, never forget it. I repeat again. When someone gives you even a small glass of water, never forget it.
You need to be grateful. That way you will please your God. You need to be grateful. God will remember you. Never be discouraged. Now I want to speak to people who help others. Never be discouraged. Do not stop to help others. Continue to help. Even they do not recognize what you are doing. Because even they do not say thank you. Continue to do the best. Continue to help people. Continue to help people. God is seeing what you are doing. God knows what you are doing. He will remember you. People may not remember you. But God will remember you. Your neighbor may not remember you. But God will remember you. And God will fight for you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Never stop to do the best. That's why you may see people are afraid to help, to continue to help others. They say, okay, I cannot continue to help others. I stopped to help others. I am tired. Remember, I helped that person. He didn't say thank you. I helped the other one. He didn't say thank you. And I helped the other one and he came and insulted me. Again, do not stop. God will remember you. Hallelujah. Okay, the Bible says in Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 5.
Mukitabu cha Jeremiah, chapitre ya 17, verse 5.
Yes. The Bible says, this is what the Lord says. Curse is the one who trusts in men. Wow. I repeat again. Jeremiah 17, verse 5. This is what says the Lord. Curse is the one who trusts in man. And make the flesh his strength. And turn his heart from the Lord. As I told you, men remain a man. God is speaking to you, my sister and my brother. You who rely on your job. You who rely on your husband as your God. You who rely on your wife as your God. Do you who rely on your money? Do you who rely on your car or your house? God is speaking to you who rely on your children. God says this. Curse is the one who trusts, who rely on men. My brother and my sister. Curse means you are separate from good things. Curse means you are not deserved to receive anything good in your life. Curse means you are a friend of failure. Curse means you are a friend of sorrow. Curse means you are a friend of poverty. You want to be blessed. Today God says stop to rely on men. I know you understand what I'm talking. I know you know what you are relying on. But God is calling you today. Come out from where you are. Come out from where you are. Let us stand up in the presence of God. My friend and my sister, what did you catch today? What did you understand today? You are afraid of living. You are saying, if I do not rely on that person, maybe my life will be bad. Maybe you are living with someone, it's not your husband or it's not your wife, and you say, if I stop that, my life will be bad. You know the work that you are doing doesn't please God, and you are continuing to do it because you are afraid. God is calling you today. God is calling you, my sister. Today is the day the Lord God has made for you. God is calling you to change your life. God wants to change your life. God wants to change your life. God wants to hear your prayer. God is calling you today, saying, call me. Call me, I will answer you. So before I finish, if you are with us and you know you do not have the Lord in your life, if you know your life is far from the Lord, yes, in the church we may say you are a Christian, but you know really you are far from the Lord, you may pray with me this prayer. If you know in your life there is some sins, you cannot abandon it, you are going to pray with me. If you know really, even when you pray, you believe that your prayer God doesn't hear it, you are going to pray because you are far from God. And if you believe that and you see you suffer a lot in sin, you are going to pray with me. I want to tell you, God is ready to forgive your sin. God loves you so much. That's why he sent Jesus. That's why he came to be crucified. He knew the day as today you will repent from your sin. He knew the day as today you will give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. But today, you are afraid because you are far from your Lord. Because I know any person who has Jesus does not have a fear. But you are going to pray with me. Say, Father God, I come before you and I recognize I am a sinner. Since I was born, I was living in sin. I was raised in sin. Lord God, but today, because of the Lord Jesus Christ, because of the cross of Jesus Christ, I surrender my life to you, my God. Forgive me, Father. Forgive all my sins. I want to be pure. I want you to purify me, Lord. Change my life. Change my life. Transform me, Lord. Hold my hand. I want my name to be written in the book of life. Lord, from now, I refuse sin. I refuse sin. I refuse sin. Satan, go away far from me. You're not my friend. You're not my savior. Father God, write my name in the book of life. From now, Lord, I am yours. 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 I belong to you. From now and forever. In Jesus Christ's name. Amen, amen, amen. Let's pray. Father, we pray and say thank you. You start with us as the Alpha and the Omega. Now we are going back home, Lord. We want you to protect us. We want you to bless us. And I pray for those who did not come. In the name of Jesus.
Lord, bring them back here. Bring them back here. In the name of Jesus. Remember them. Remember their problems. Heal them. Give them courage to come in your presence. Father, I pray for this coming week. I bless this Monday. I bless this Tuesday. I pray this coming Wednesday. I pray this coming Thursday. I pray this coming Friday. I pray this coming Saturday. I pray this coming Sunday. In the name of Jesus, bless everyone. Bless us. Bless everyone. Bless us. Bless everyone. Bless us. Bless everyone. Bless us. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. And we ask for the glory of God.
Shall Yeshua.